Hello everyone, I will show you a unique way of modeling. It is based on working with geoprimitives, but it can also be used for simple objects. Using primitives gives you grid adjustment on the entire model at any moment. Duplicate the primitive and get a separate primitive with the same settings. Now you can change the settings of the new primitive. I will use a primitive to position the objects correctly. So, now we will merge them into a layer. For this we select all the objects that we need, and make the object to which we need the union active. Press plus a new layer will appear and select the type of layer in it. In the layer object panel, you can see the objects that are in the active layer. When you click on them, you can highlight them. On the Boolean layer there are buttons to hide layer objects and disable the layer. When you click on the Boolean layer, all the objects that are in the layer are highlighted. If you duplicate objects that are in a layer, then it will also be in the same layer. But we want it to be a different layer, so we make our object active again and install a new layer on the difference layer. If you have primitives of the same type selected, then you can adjust their parameters simultaneously with pressing the Alt key. In the difference layer in the objects panel, you have a slice button on each object. If you have disabled the layer objects from visibility, then you will not be able to adjust them all only by the active one. When pressed, the slice width adjustment is also added. Let's try to make them a little more interesting. Turn on the dual mesh function on geo primitives and add grids. By superimposing a grid on a cutting primitive, you also superimpose it on the object you are cutting. We'll make cutouts from the bottom. We just need to duplicate them. We can also move them around the object, rotate and scale them. Disable the layer objects so that they do not interfere with us. You can also use it this way. I have an add-in for working with Link-Irv. You can also use it or any way convenient for you. I'll run the geo primitive along the curve. So let's set 3. Now we use the geo primitive settings to make it wider. Select the curve and our object with layers and add a new layer. If you use complex bundles, it is better to disable some layers for optimization. This will be the difference layer. Let's increase the radius. Look, since this is the last layer, it affects all the previous ones, so the cylinders have suffered. Disable the selection of layer objects to make it more convenient for us. Now just move our curve layer above the layer where we added the cylinders. You can also adjust the segmentation of these cuts through the geo primitive. Let's return the disabled layer. It's all right now. I will hide the objects of this layer. We have a geo primitive so we don't have to look at what's on the curve. It seems that it was better this way. You can also add a transverse curve. I'll turn off this layer for now, it's heavy. Let me remind you that you can continue to adjust all your primitives. You can also select one layer, disable the selection of layers and select objects of another layer through the Objects panel. And now with the Alt button to adjust all geocylinders in general. You can also add a bevel layer and see how you have it, find a place where it does not work correctly and configure the primitive so that everything is fine. I've got enough to turn around here. And here? Everything is fine now. Maybe sometimes the solution will be to move. In the bevel layer, you have settings for its width and segmentation. When layer objects are enabled, you can select an object by clicking on the grid on the object, or through the list of layer objects. You can remove the layer through a minus. Now I will show you one of the advantages of this modeling. You can disable granularity, reduce segmentation, duplicate an object and apply it. Thus, to obtain a low poly model. Yes, you may need to triangulate, make a UV. Then you can add details and segments, duplicate them back and get a highly polygonal model. I also have the coolest add-in for auto naming the whole scene for baking. You can watch a video about it, maybe you will like it. It simplifies this whole process for you in the preview video, it is very well shown. Maybe I should make it more flexible. If you liked the project, I will be glad of your support. Everything didn't fit in one video. See you in the next one.